Welcome back to another bike tour, guys. Today we found ourselves in Wheatley, Ontario. Not a big town, not a small town, kind of mid-size. This town is kind of unique. Now I'm going to stop partway through and explain to you why it's unique, but for now, let's get the bike out. Let's go for a ride. Guys, we're starting off on Erie Street North at Olmsted Drive. That's the entrance to the arena. We're gonna make our way downtown. I was wondering if we could get up to the next road or not, but I don't think we can. We're gonna have to go around. I will explain why that road's closed in just a minute. We're gonna go down Walker Ave. Try and take the detour around. we're on the main street. That's Talbot at the intersection with Erie Street. Now I'm going to explain to you why this town is unique. All right, so on the other side of that green tarp over there, there used to be a restaurant called The Pogue. A couple of years ago, there was a gas leak underground in the area of that restaurant. After a couple of years, through no fault of the residents of this town, let's just say political parties were involved, different levels of government. And I'll leave it at that. That's for another video. However, I believe it was August 26, around 6 p.m. I was working that night. I was dispatched to attend this area right here for an explosion. I got here to find complete chaos. Now, I do have pictures of what it looked like. I'll put them in a different video. My point here is my cruiser was parked down by that porta potty down there on the left. I was stationed right here. After a few hours of scene control and crowd control and whatnot, it was extremely hot. I returned to my car to find to find a cooler beside my left front wheel. I opened the cooler. It was full of water, pop, Gatorade, and ice. My point here is, in the midst of the chaos that was this explosion in this small town, the people in this town were taking care of us, which I found amazing. I can also tell you that for months and months, there was 24-hour security, police security. Fire department was on scene for 24 hours a day, 7 days a week as well. Virtually every day, someone in this town brought us food and water to keep us comfortable. And they're saying thanks for us being here. This town got rocked, and they were still taking care of us. So it says a lot for the people in this town. Let's continue our ride. We are on Little Street South right now. And we're going to go up to Moore Street, and then we're going to turn right. Turn south here on Erie Street and head down by the lake.
All right, we're gonna make our way over to the harbor. I notice my camera's got a tilt to it, guys. Sorry about that. I'll try and get that fixed for next time. This is where all the fishing boats come in off Lake Erie. Right here, we'll turn into the harbor and have a look at Lake Erie. Boat launched to Lake Erie. Y'all do a little history on Lake Erie. That can be one nasty lake, but the fishing's good. All right, let's head over to the beach side. see if we can get all the way around here. I don't know if we can or not. Nope, you can't. We're just on the other side of the harbor here. And this up here is the Wheatley Beach. I did some videos a while back, I think it was last summer, on the cleanest beaches in our area. This was the number one cleanest beach, taken care of by the people that live here.
Well, that's going to do it for today's bike tour of Wheatley. There's plenty more to see here, but the harbor is a nice area, the beach is a nice area. And the downtown, hopefully it comes back soon. They just lifted some restrictions there, so, and opened up the main road. So hopefully that's a step in the right direction. Anyway, that's all I got. I hope you all enjoyed that. Hopefully we visit another town near you soon. Later. Oh, hit that subscribe button. We'd love to have you.